Hey, what's going on, everybody? So I just got out of a period of relative hardship. Basically, I was in over my head for 2 months because I didn't have a job and I'd been let go from my last position. So I just wanted to say it wasn't performance related or anything like that. They just didn't need me anymore. Basically, I was hired on as a contractor because there was a lot of work to be done during an intermediary period where the firm was facing an inordinate amount of work, and management had promised me several times when I was there, "Oh yeah, we got more work for you down the pipeline." Oh shit, no we don't. So bye. Yeah, an order came down from upper management basically saying, "Hey, we need you to reduce overhead. So that contractor you got, can you get rid of him?" And so I got the boot. And it was a very corporate setting, so that's fine. I liked my manager and personnel that I was working with, but at the same time, it was just like, damn, I am out of a job. So, yeah, not my proudest moment. I wasn't expecting it to take 2 months to find the next gig. Well, when I say job, I should say career, because, you can pretty much get a job pretty quick. I'm talking about a occupation that actually pays worth a damn and requires a brain cell or two between your head and correlates with your background as far as, well, what you went to school for, and the working experience that you got up to that point. So the good news is, hey, I don't have to look for a job for a while. Or actually, here's the thing. So they like, kind of brought me in for two interviews and said, "Listen, we couldn't help but notice that you jumped around a lot." And it's just like, well, yeah, I jumped around a lot. It was right after the 2008 to 2012 like financial dip in the marketplace. Of course, I'm going to be jumping around a lot. I got out of school and the job market was still fucked. Basically, they wanted a sense of commitment because, while they think there's a lot of value in my work experience and stuff, they couldn't help but feel as though they're going to train me on things that are unique to the position, and then I was going to jump in 3 months, which would be admittedly a dick move. So they're willing to pay me like closer to what I was making as a contractor, which is pretty good. But at the same time, it's like, So yeah, I don't know what to expect going forward. I say this all like all of this to you all because I'm sure most of you have noticed that there was a pretty significant dip in videos coming out, at least furry related videos. When I wasn't putting in job applications and filling out job applications and going to interviews and stuff like that, I was pretty much just playing video games to sort of like, cope with my situation and working on some of my like hobbies on the way, namely art and stuff like that. A lot of time was spent on VR chat because it was sort of like the comfort zone for me to just sort of like lose myself for a couple hours each day and interact with people that were cool. But yeah, now I'm gonna have to buckle down and reacclimate myself to a working schedule. So I'm not going to be able to like, stay up hours upon hours at night doing stuff, unfortunately. However, what I will try to do is between my personal studies and hobbies, I will try to get some more furry related content released, like week to week or, on the weekends and stuff like that when I'm not going off to do fuck whatever. One major thing is I'm feeling cautiously optimistic about the job itself when I get in. Obviously, I got a lot of bills to pay and stuff like that. My romantic prospects, there's only one person of lead that I have. I mentioned in this video here, but it's a lot to think about, So I hope you enjoy today's episode of Amorous, and I will definitely jump to I Promise and Great Troubles after this because, Major Minor can wait. I think Echo is still pretty good, has a lot of potential there, and various other things. But yeah. Also, I'm going to go to Biggest Little Fur Con in about a month, so keep an eye out for like videos on that. A lot has changed in my life, which, I might comment in a future video, but it does have bearing on, what I've been trying to focus on and what I've trying to been pursue. So, just something to think about along with this brief interlude in my employment history. It's still very hard to say what I want to do for the rest of my life, I have some ideas right now, but it's more of a change in perspective and, you know, paradigm shift, if you will, and sort of considering what's more realistic in the near future and what would be more rewarding to me, you know, both on a spiritual level and a professional level, you know, in the near to the late future. So I'm going to let the video roll here to showcase my experiences in great troubles. I hope you all enjoy. I will catch you next video, guys. Take care. Peace.